Respected Shri Ashok Vajpeyi, Ms. Sharon Lowen, Dr. Pratibha, Dr. Suresh, Goel and friends, I, on behalf of Legends of India, welcome you to this very interesting episode of Shanta Serbjeet Art Appreciation Lecture Series. The topic this evening is Art and Culture in Education. For those who are new to Legends of India, I take this opportunity to introduce Legends of India, a society trying to preserve the tradition of Indian cultural heritage for the younger generation, as we need to infuse in the younger generation the greatness and importance of our rich cultural heritage. During the past 19 years, we have been organizing music and theatre festivals and art exhibitions across the country. Our endeavor has always been about young, upcoming talents to share the platform with the established legends.
I thought that in view of the importance of how we people take us as cultural entities, it's important to understand how this is actually built up at the very basic level of education, starting from the schools to the colleges. And I go to many conferences, and there is often a kind of a feeling that we are not giving enough importance to the subjects of art and culture in our educational syllabus. I thought that it's high time that we have a discussion to see why that is the case, why it is not given that much importance, considering that it is very fundamental to our own entity, our own identity, and still is not there really. And very often in the schools, you do have a dance teacher who appears about 1 week or 2 weeks before there is a big function, and there is a public personality coming there. They develop, they choreograph something, and then the dance teacher vanishes the next day. So that's a kind of a level of art teaching that we have there.
So this is not formal, but on their own, be it art, be it fine arts, be it music, both Western and Indian, be it theatre, we have excelled. And if we have excelled, then also we need to look at what are the stories that we tell. These stories are also a reflection of the times. So today, when you have Nukkad Natas, then they tell a story, the story of how society should transform itself. Much as we may, you know, almost look down at that and say what is happening to the puritanical space of theatre, but each story that students create or those that are directed are a reflection of the times, of their own yearnings and their own interpretation of what is happening, and that becomes extremely important. But all this is happening in the informal, what is called as the extracurricular space or the extramural space. Institutions are not able to weave it in, into the curricula, or it happens in the non-formal space. That is, you, if you can afford it, you go and you take those courses, or you will do that. So those are certain elitist spaces, which also therefore do define, you know, you have a divide of a kind. If your parents could afford and send you, or you lived in a state where everybody sings, or every round the corner, down every street there is a music school, there are such states, then you imbibe it. But if you live in a state where it is said the only culture we know is, you know, yes, you said it. I did not want to use that banal word. But even there, while talking of that, the moment I hear the real Punjabi music, the reed and so on, you wonder, you say, my God, the richness of the language and the richness of this music does not come down to generations and generations, and least it for today's generation.
When you invited me to speak on this subject, I realized that anyone who is attending already believes that the arts are important, or you wouldn't be here. So this is definitely preaching to the choir. So I thought I'll start by just sharing a few quotes about arts and education. I think many of you know these, but Plato, as you know, he said, to sing well and to dance is to be well educated. He also said, in order to be a good soldier, it's necessary to know how to dance. And Nietzsche, whatever you think of Nietzsche, he had a lot to say about dance. He said, we should consider every day lost on which we have not danced at least once. I do not know what the spirit of a philosopher could more wish to be than a good dancer. For the dance is his ideal, also his fine art. Finally, also the only kind of piety he knows, his divine service. Dancing in all its forms cannot be excluded from the curriculum of all noble education. Dancing with the feet, with ideas, with words, and need I add that one must also be able to dance with the pen. Now, focusing on dance is obviously quotes in every field.
Television is now creating a new kind of culture. It is not merely art and culture as we understood it. Not even the digital technology, etc., whatever they may be doing, they can enhance the value of culture. They can perhaps disseminate it better or to more people, make it more, as you said, democratic and accessible. But the kind of things that the television system is doing, in this country at least, is to enhance all those values which are against the values, the liberal values of plurality, of understanding, of dialogue, of accommodation, of others in this cultural stream that we have inherited. Now, in the school education, it is not as if this matter has not been addressed before. The state of, in 2006, the NCRT published a position paper which was on arts, music, dance and theatre. They examined the state status, and there were very eminent people on the in the group who examined what is the state, and they made a large number of recommendations.